Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Are you thinking of studying tourism and hospitality? Or are you just looking at different university degrees to choose from and are considering or just interested in getting to know what tourism and hospitality is about? If any of the two questions is a yes, then you came to the right video. And even if none of the question is a yes, but you're still curious to know what a recent undergraduate has to say about the degree, then you are also more than welcome to join. First of all, as I just mentioned, I have just officially graduated from the degree of Tourism and Hospitality Management this June 2020 in said University of Barcelona. Well, officially not, since I have not had the chance to have any ceremony or anything like that due to the whole Corona situation, but yes, technically I have just graduated. Although, to be honest, during this past year I have only had to do the final degree project, so technically like all my lectures and lessons and so on ended already on June last year. But I also must say that I'm a bit of an exceptional case since I took more subjects on the previous years in order to be able to finish the degree sooner. And I could not be happier with how I did things because thanks to that I have been able to work full-time since June 2019. And I don't say this to show off or anything, but mostly to make you aware that at least in Spain it is possible to take more subjects and more credits than the ones that are usually entitled in order to finish your degree earlier. Because when I started, I had no clue about it, and if I had known about it earlier, I would have taken even more subjects earlier, and I probably would have finished already last year with everything. In any case, the practical implications of having finished the degree 1 year earlier have been that I have been able to work, as I just mentioned, for one extra year than my colleagues. I have also been able to gain a lot of professional experience and be better prepared for the labor market. And now looking back, I see it was certainly a great idea to have done that because I currently have a job and many of my colleagues who just finished the degree just can't find a job. And of course it is not just their fault because this current situation does not help, but sometimes making extra efforts of taking extra lessons, working on the side always of my studies, does end up paying off. This is why I always have the philosophy that in whatever thing I do in life, I need to give it my 100%. Because I know that in the future I will for sure have more regrets for not having given it my all than for having done too much. In the case of this specific video, going 100% in things means that I had very clear from the very beginning or from when I found out that it was possible to take more subjects that I wanted to finish the degree as soon as possible, and I was trying to get every year the maximum amount of subjects that I could take and of course always trying to do my best in each and every subject. Alright, after discussing a bit my personal experience and background, let's go now and see the details of the degree, the subjects and recommendations and basically everything I have to say about it. With all of this, my goal will be to create a picture of what studying this degree implies, also the career opportunities that you have after studying this degree, and even a bit of the salaries and recommendations in this sense, based all on my personal experience. Because the worst thing you can have is to have expectations that are not met in the end. And although it doesn't have to be, choosing the degree that you study will, in most of the cases, determine your professional future. Although I want to remark that it doesn't have to be and that you can study something and end up working in something completely different. That said, and before I continue with the video, I would very much appreciate if you could hit that like button, if you are enjoying the video, if you find the content useful, and so on. And now I will try to put all of the different things I could think of regarding this degree and that I think that are very important and worth mentioning and especially relevant if you are planning on studying tourism and hospitality. The first one is that the degree in general is kind of like studying business administration but more centered towards the tourism and hospitality industry. Although I must say that there are way too few subjects regarding economic, finance and so on, which I think that are very very important and much more important than maybe learning about the whole tourism overall, which of course is important, but I think that the weight should be much higher within finances, economic topics and so on. Moreover, at least from my experience, I can confirm that it is a very easy degree and that it doesn't require much effort outside of your lessons in order to be able to pass it. And at this point of the video comes a very important point, in my opinion, which are internships. If you study tourism, yes, it is easier than doing other degrees, such as, for instance, economics, engineering, and so on. But if you really want to stand out from the rest, you need to gain professional experience as soon as possible in order to finish the degree better prepared than your colleagues. A perfect way to do so is through internships or part-time jobs. Not only it is a great way to get experience, but also it is great to get to know which things you like and which things you don't like. Since in tourism there are many different branches, from hotels, travel agencies, airlines, and even within each one of them there are many different positions to aspire to, from customer service, revenue management, finance, HR, more operational departments. And something super interesting and very important in my opinion is that if you are curious enough during your experiences in these internships, you can also get to know the salaries that your colleagues are getting. For me, salaries are a very important thing and something that I certainly look at. Because yes, of course I want to do a job that I enjoy, but I also want to make sure that I'm making the best use of my time possible and that I also have the best working conditions, because nobody works because they want to, we all work because we get paid for it. And by doing internships and working in different places, I can tell you that you'll learn a lot about salaries, what to expect in different positions. And now, of course, you have Google and you can Google things. And I really encourage you to Google the salaries and so on, because I think that it is a main source of disappointment in people working and specifically in certain departments within the tourism industry. And just to give you an example of what somebody who has been super, super devoted to the degree and to trying to grow professionally as much as possible has done, here is how many professional experience I have had before finishing my degree. I have worked in England for a summer as a waiter. Afterwards, I did an internship in hospitality research in my university. I worked as a waiter in France for a summer. I did an internship as a receptionist in a 5-star hotel in Barcelona. I did an internship as assistant general manager in a hotel in Ibiza. And this actually went super bad. And I ended up leaving before I wanted to. So although the position sounds very good, it was certainly horrible. Then I also was a check-in agent for a touristic apartment management company in Barcelona, a very small one by the way. And then in that same company, I became human resources manager, although I must say that it was kind of like a startup, so I was kind of like the only person there, together with interns. And lastly, this February, I started working as human resources coordinator in Germany, and this is where I'm currently working at. So we have that before finishing my degree, I have been working in 8 different positions, and with this I have learned so much of what I want to do and what I don't want to do. And I must say that I have changed really my mind from when I started the degree and I wanted to become a general manager from a hotel to now, in which I really don't know what I want to do, but I know that the general manager position is not what I personally want to aspire to. Okay. An important thing that you need to master, yes or yes, if you are going to be in the tourism industry, and I would say that even if you are not in the tourism industry, you should also master these, are languages. The more, the better, but English is essential. You do not know what the world will bring to you, but having the ability to communicate in many different languages can help you set apart from the rest. You have the whole 4 years of the degree, and actually you could have already started before. And if you still are not there, then please make sure to start with that, to learn new languages, practice your skills, and so on. Networking. In today's world, it is not so much about the mark that you end up getting in your degree, but about the connections you make during this time. Of course, this should not exempt you from trying to work as hard as possible and trying to always get the highest mark, because you never know where it can lead to, and it certainly has helped me a lot, at least from my personal experience. But what really, really sets you apart and what will help you in the future will be the connections that you make during the degree that you study. You need to think that your classmates, even your teachers, might be very good connections in the future, and you might get very good offers thanks to them. Now, something super important that I want to leave very clear so you are not disappointed. The fact that you study tourism and hospitality management does not mean that you will finish the degree and you will become the hotel manager straight away. No. In most of the cases, this implies very hard work and it is not easy to achieve. And with everything in life, if this is your goal and what you want to get to, then I'm sure that you will find a way to get there. But just bear in mind that it will not be easy. Finally, related to this, remember that making the most of this degree or any degree only depends on you. Many people complain that tourism is a bad degree and so on, but it is also the same people who don't even go to the classes, they spend their afternoons playing video games instead of doing internships and gaining professional experience. And then don't be surprised if you are this kind of people if you then end up spending the rest of your life just working as a receptionist. And now I said receptionist, don't take it wrong if you're a receptionist, there's nothing wrong with that, but it is just often referred as the lowest position that you can aspire to within the tourism industry. Now let's go over the different professional profiles that you can aspire to after having completed this degree. On that, first of all, I want to mention that little by little, more disruptive companies are starting to care less about what you studied in terms of degree and more about which are your skills and what you know really about. What I mean by that is that you can study tourism, but then get super interested about programming, then spend maybe every afternoon or whatever studying programming, practicing and so on, and then at the end of your degree, get hired as a junior software programmer because of your skills and not because of the degree that you studied. But unfortunately, nowadays, the majority of the companies are still very old-fashioned and having a degree does make a difference. That said, I think that tourism can be a very good option if you are not sure about what you want to do, or of course it's a good option if you already know that you want to study that. The reason for that is that you can study tourism and then end up getting hired or working in many different aspects and even outside the tourism industry. I mean, you can study tourism and end up in finance, HR, in sales, marketing, customer service, whether it is at the airport, maybe in the call center of a company, in the front desk, working in a restaurant or bars, or you can also end up doing administrative jobs. I just like it because it offers a very wide range of opportunities. On the other hand, having such a wide range of opportunities and the degree being so general also means that you are in disadvantage when applying for very specific jobs, for instance in marketing, when you're competing with other candidates who study just marketing, because most probably they will be better prepared than you and companies will most likely hire them before you. This is why I think that it is great to do internships in more specific departments such as, for instance, finance, sales, HR, or marketing. So my advice would be to, yes, maybe if you study tourism, do one internship in the reception of a hotel because you get to see how it works and so on. But then try to go into more specific departments because it will be thanks to these specific experiences that you will be able to get into the departments of sales, marketing, finance, and so on. Because without any internship experience, I think that it's super hard for you, having studied tourism, to get into these departments. Mostly because it is super, super easy to get hired for operational departments such as the front desk, restaurants, housekeeping, maintenance, and so on. And you can come from any background and end up working there. While to go into more specific departments, I think that you really need to have some kind of previous experience. To end with the video, in terms of salaries, I would say that the tourism industry does not pay great salaries, specifically the operational departments such as the reception, like front desk, F&B, housekeeping, and so on. Also, it is usually these operational departments that offer the worst working conditions because they tend to involve working on weekends and also late nights and so on. Then if you go to more specific positions such as marketing, HR, finance and so on, you get better paid and also you have better working conditions and you have the classic usually schedule of 9-to-5 job. And from each of these points, you can grow professional into supervisor, manager, director and so on. And also my advice, and I already said it before, would be to go on Google, search for the different salaries that you can expect for the different positions and have that clear in mind when defining your future. But from my personal experience, and as I already said before, the operational departments are the ones that pay the worst. And finally, in terms of salaries, you can of course always start your own business, make it successful, and then end up getting super nice salary while being self-employed. After this point, and now to finish up, I want to mention that I'm super happy with the choice I made. It was thanks to studying tourism that I am where I am right now, and I'm super happy with it. It is true that if I had to study again, I would now go for a more finance, economic, or just business administration degree, but that's just because of my personal experience, and I also got interested into that thanks to having studied tourism, so it's not a bad thing. And also the cool thing is that you can study a degree and then see that you like something else, do a master, specialize on that, or you can always do self-learning and learn more about the things that you are really interested on. And now with the internet, it is super easy to do that. And as I said before, it is not so much about what you study, but about how hard you work for your goals. If you work hard, I am sure that you will succeed. In any case, thank you very much for watching the video. I hope that you got a bit of a picture of what to expect when studying the tourism and hospitality degree. And I hope that you got something useful out of it. If you did, then please make sure to give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you are not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.